Live on the air here on the Rafael Duke Page Guy channel. Decided I'd be broadcasting some WWE 2K17. Just some random gameplay, really. Nothing really planned in advance. No, this is, ironically, this is universe mode, but this is like my random universe mode where I just play the matches, let it go out, set the rivalries, but that's about it. Unlike my other universe mode that I've set up, which I need to start broadcasting soon. I'll actually be broadcasting on Twitch, my universe mode, to avoid copyrights and stuff. Because the last time I broadcasted universe mode on my YouTube channel, I got a copyright strike. And we have one loyal viewer that is watching us. Welcome, viewer. This matchup first is my universe mode. It's the feud that's been going on since SummerSlam. Where heel Sasha Banks will be facing face Bayley, will be fighting a face Bayley inside Hell in a Cell for the Women's Championship.
And introducing the champion from Boston, Massachusetts, she is the WWE Women's Champion, Sasha Banks.
The WWE Sasha Universe Banks can't get enough of their champion. So, listen to this reaction.
They don't call this Hell in a Cell.
So I'll be broadcasting some universe mode, but again, this is like random universe mode. There's gonna do this match. I'm actually at the Hell in a Cell pay-per-view card, so if you guys wanna know more, I'm actually at that pay-per-view card right now in my universe mode. Just gonna make sure everything's working properly on my. Alright, I am live. I'm sure I'm being live on here, but I am live right now. So if you go through my channel, you can watch this awesome gameplay. So WWE Raw Women's Championship. I didn't put in this universe mode. Yeah, I only have one title and stuff. I didn't put all the titles in.
Man, social media is abuzz with the outcome of this match.
Right, here and we
the
go.
WWE
Bayley
seems to be torn.
Sasha Banks.
Singles action is underway, and
Bayley,
in this one, I wouldn't attempt to predict what's going to happen. I'd just be ready for anything. Sometimes that's all you can do.
Well, neither one of these competitors has a lot of love for the other, and that's going to become clear right about now. Both these superstars are going to fight and no matter what, these are the types of nights they'll write about in the WWE annals for years to come.
Yeah, thought I'd talk a little bit also baby stuff
been a
right
wild
now.
Ride for Sasha Banks,
the
but that
biggest
title reign may very well
going on
come
right
to an
now,
end here tonight.
On WWE.
Early in the going here. What do you think she needs to do to defend her title?
Of course,
it
we have TLC coming up this Sunday from
Everybody
Dallas, Texas. My predictions video is already up. In case any of you want to watch it.
But there's also a
predictions video on TLC on the tables match between Becky Lynch and Alexa Bliss. The no DQ match between Carmella and Nikki Bella, the chairs match between one Baron Corbin and one Kalisto, and of course, the ladder match between The Miz and Ziggler, and the TLC main event between Dolph Ziggler and AJ Styles. This also kind of, I guess, can be used as a reply to someone who actually mentioned in the comments on my video that supposedly the strongest rumor for the Rumble at the world title was
the champ's on the defensive now.
German.
She might be a little caught
Was
by the
Undertaker
challenger.
Versus AJ Styles.
And these divas have given
but
us
right
an
now, from what I heard, is WWE's planning to have Dean versus AJ last
and these women have been pretty
Christmas.
Evenly matched thus far.
Going from there. Also, me and Simon were a little upset in the last couple of days. Since the Elimination Chamber was announced
that.
To be
she
in Phoenix, Arizona next
She's
in 2017,
okay.
It's actually at the Talking Stick Resort Arena.
Yeah. I guess you could say
not,
she was.
I know, like,
the
there's the
one.
Jobbing.com Arena, there's the Talking Stick Resort, which is where the Phoenix Suns play. And that, ironically, that event's actually going to be a Raw exclusive event. I'm trying to see. I can't put it through the wall, can I? Let me pull it through the cell wall. Alright, I can do it. I just need to do it the right way.
And it's Bayley feeling
so yeah, Elimination Rules X is a Raw exclusive pay-per-view, while Fastlane, which is taking place in March in Milwaukee.
Sasha Banks able to get out of the way.
Reverse this, Bayley. Come on, Bayley. Wrong way. Come about halfway here. God, this camera angle is bad. Here we go.
The champ being put to the test in a major way. We might be witnessing the final moments of her championship reign. I must say,
God damn it, I can't
seem
to be able to put her through the fucking wall.
I'll tell you, I'm getting tired of seeing her take the action to the outside.
Oh, I had a Norm G moment, which is probably putting her through the wall. Hey, thumbs up. Oh, shit, that was a glitchy ass thumbs up.
Means this one
what
might
the
be
hell?
Over. Oh, baby,
what
her
the
opponent
hell?
Is in bad, bad shape here.
Why did Jerry say her partner? This ain't no tag team match. Oh crap, I had it. I messed up, I had it. I want to make this match like extreme to all hell, so. Ooh, the CPU is also kind of pretty weedy. They'll usually just do like random moves. Or they'll just toss you back inside the ring half the time. You don't like fighting on the outside. God damn it, I had it. Oh shit.
Thank you for joining us on this Halloween night. I assure you we have no tricks planned for you, only treats. And she's back in the ring now.
Here we go, back into the ring.
This isn't
going
to end well
leave
for somebody.
The ring.
I can guarantee you that, King. That's why you're the best color analyst in the business. Oh, thanks. The champ counters, and you see the result.
Right off the post again. The CPU is also a very, very spammy.
Bringing it back into the ring.
No, like throws me back into the ring.
She appears to be extra
the CPU
slow
this
regaining
year is
her base.
So retarded. Even on Legend.
Beginning to look bad for her.
Oh shit!
She's the number one contender, which means she's so close to becoming champion. Sasha Banks looking for the pin. Look at this action, and there's still plenty to come. Oh yeah, let's go.
You're slipping into the saw wall, I don't know. Oh.
When she gets in attack mode, look out. Oh, looking to make a statement here.
Bayley's left again.
Oh, Bayley! Oh, no! Watch out! Down to the floor. Oh, hard. Not where you want to be.
Throws her out of the ring.
She's going to need to dig down deep if she wants
actually
to keep going
now.
Actually,
a cool moment for this feud where Sasha Banks is actually facing Carmella.
She's
on
really
SmackDown.
Putting her stamp on this match now.
Tossing in the middle of nowhere. Yeah. Stomp. Pick me up. Throw me back in the ring.
Folks, I would not be surprised if we were looking at the crowning of a new champion here tonight. I don't recall the last time I saw a more focused challenger.
And
that's it. That's got to be it. Sasha Banks. Now that's a finishing move, people.
I kicked out.
Uh-oh, Sasha Banks is looking
Banks
at it.
Statement. Oh, crap. Thanks, statement.
That's how you make this crowd stand on its feet. Oh, look out. It's crucial that she figures out how to bounce back right now. Whoa! Shoulders down. Championship on the line.
Two.
Look at Bayley making her
move. Bayley, here we go.
You can guarantee her opponent's an agonizing pain.
Bayley kicked out of it. Maybe I'll hook it out.
She's looking to kick this thing into high gear out here near the Savage Steel Hell in a Cell.
Are you kidding me? Doesn't she realize how dangerous that cell is?
I'm fucking
The ring may not be big enough for what's about to unfold here.
Are you kidding me? This entire arena may not be big enough. Bayley is taking all out control right now.
Whoa! And she fights her way out.
Invisible.
And she wills her way out.
I pointed towards the other the directions, okay? The fuck is wrong
with you? WWE fans watching this match all around the world.
We want to say hi to them, all the countries, even Manila, where I use their envelopes.
Manila's not a country.
God damn it, I had it again. And now, gets me up.
Goes
like back
she
into
wants
the
to
ring.
Inside the ring. And I can't blame her. Do it.
Gets
I'm
out
not
of
sure
ring.
If she knows what planet she's on after that.
I'm down and out here. I'm moving. I'm
back
serving.
Inside now. We're seeing two outstanding athletes looking to prove their dominance in there. But only one
pinfall.
Can walk out
victorious.
Look at this goal. She's looking for the win. And the shoulder's up now. That's a kick out.
Nice. Oh, it doesn't get any closer to three than
count
that.
Zero for the fucking computer.
Bailey saw it coming. Sasha Banks is on the attack. And it appears Bayley is starting to hit the wall physically now.
Oh, Bayley is looking worse for the wear right now.
Wow, those finishers she used earlier. See, great counter. You can see the confidence just beaming from her right now.
There doesn't seem to be any slowing her down now.
Oh, look at the emotion. Here comes Bayley.
Good grief.
This is insane. Does this building have a curfew? I feel like we might be here.
Bayley.
Yeah.
And now
and
for the big one.
Here's in real agony. Well, this might be the worst yet.
Both of these competitors have so much resolve. It's going to take a minor miracle to keep one of them down.
And now the avalanche. Bayley the belly off the top turnbuckle.
Bayley.
Oh,
and
yeah.
That's it.
That's what I'm talking about.
Could this be
that's
it?
Poor Bayley the belly. That's how you get it. And it is. Bayley's the new champion.
But I wish that match could
be. She's the new champion. Yay. Can't even bring on the phone. Something else to go. Yeah, survived the Hell in a Cell. Bayley has survived.
Here's your winner and the new WWE
Women's
Champion,
Bayley.
When we return, it's a battle where the participants will need to know where they are at all times.
God damn it.
We have one of our breakout talents taking on some tough competition.
We've been waiting on this one.
This is fucked up. I actually don't want to do this fucking match. Match.
with one and on to another great matchup. Get ready for tag team action. Coming up next, we have a team led by a real fan favorite in a match that will be etched in the record books.
The Ambrose vs. John Cena. John Cena, the new champ. Becky Lynch gets interrupted by Naomi. Undertaker buries Randy Orton in Hell in a Cell. Oh, we got a viewer. Alright, so these feuds are probably going to continue on until next week. I got a feeling. Let me see rivalries. Oh, crap. What the fuck is this shit? Alright, delete, delete. And Sammy Starr's been going on for a while. Let's do this from scratch. Yeah, these are going to be going until the Royal Rumble, so that's alright. Champion John Cena versus Kevin Owens. That's a good title feud. Well, look at what we got over here. We got a little David Rivera. Let's see, where is Mr. Rivera? Mr. Rivera! I'll join right back into this. Man, my eyes. Alright. So, alright, I'm just doing a random feud. I gotta do it with my tag team feud. Hopefully this will work. Against the tag team of Golden Truth. And the women's title feud. Bayley versus Nikki. Bayley versus Becky. That's better. We'll save. Alright. Main feud on SmackDown is going to be for Sami Zayn's Intercontinental title. It's going to be Sami Zayn versus how about Dolph Ziggler. My main women's title feud on here is actually going to be Sasha Banks versus Nikki. And then my random male feud, AJ versus Randy. And then my feud's hopefully set up till all the way till Rumble. It's you, Brother David. Yes, it is. Took a while for that fucking comment to come through. Why the fuck is Bayley versus Paige main eventing Raw in Pontiac, Michigan? The kind of fucking main event is that?
It was me all along.
Yes, I know it was you. You're not someone that hides, like, you don't hide yourself, E. You're not very, what would we say, mystical? We all know it was you. Oh,
keep
shit.
Keep it a secret.
Yeah, well, you suck. Well, it kind of sucks to keep it a secret when your name, David Rivera, shows up.
Well, I'm popular. Can't help that.
Well, it's not that you're popular, just that we know it's you, David. If you use, like, a secret name, then maybe it would have been a secret. But it says David Rivera, and I don't know more than just one David Rivera.
Yeah. No, you might. My name is very common. You'd be surprised.
I know a lot of Davids, I just don't know a lot of David Riveras.
Yeah.
Oh, I got another viewer. Probably you again.
Yeah, so I can see what's going on in this damn stream here.
I'm just playing random 2K, W2K, nothing really Nothing really supposed to go on. It's just me playing some WWE, some World Wrestling Entertainment. Maybe I can play some WWE online with a certain champion of the hot seat. I hear we have a new title.
Yeah, another new title to be defended.
Yes, I think it's time we have to crown the champion. I mean, you can't just award the title to yourself.
Well, you can have a tournament for the title.
Or that's just a cool face idea. Me, since I'm I am the number one contender. I mean, you're not going to face Chris. Chris will not give you a challenge.
Chris is in the game.
What?
I can challenge him, put him in a triple threat.
It's going to be only Cause. It's not going to be like, you know, random wrestlers. It's only going to be Cause.
Chill.
So, unless we're just going to have like the hot seat title and just have it like, you know, be defended in random matches.
The hot seat title will be defended at Hell in a Cell.
No, the hot seat title, the hot seat champion first should be crowned at TLC between David the Instant Classic Rivera and Rafael Page Guy LeDuc. Simple as that.
That's how we challenge you to a TLC match.
Alright, let me get online and I'll make the match. Let me get on here. Private. One-on-one, TLC. And whoever grabs the briefcase, the title's inside the briefcase.
The title's inside the briefcase. Yeah, unfortunately.
Alright, where's Fort Minor Project? There he is. I did not on my call. The only calls I have are Brian Kendrick, Cedric Alexander, James Ellsworth, Johnny Gargano, Rich Swann, and TJ Perkins. Those are the only calls I have. I did not read that one myself. There was no use in playing with myself.
This is the time for it.
Yeah. Or we just use our favorite wrestlers and we just do it like that. I mean, we don't have to use yourself and all that. Like, I don't even know my own fucking moves, bro.
Let's get this underway.
Yes, so ladies and gentlemen, the first ever title match for the Hot Seat Championship of the World will be defended. It will be crowned at a TLC match at TLC. I just haven't changed the stage yet. Alright, so we're just taking our all-time favorite wrestlers, I guess.
Well, since you don't want to use the cars, create the wrestlers. Cena!
Do I go with John or should I go with someone else? Because John is not fair, he's like a 95 overall. I need to go with someone that is a little bit the same overall to make a better match. Who would be a good matchup for Christian?
It would be Mr. McMahon.
Yeah, I probably should be.
The phenomenal AJ Styles.
Yep. A matchup that probably happened in TNA.
It's a TNA match.
Yeah, it's a TNA match.
Downloaded the arena.
Probably should have.
So that P1 is not for the In the Hot Seat Championship.
What? It's not for. Okay, was it? It's for the number one contender spot, or what?
The following contest.
Or the championship
tournament.
All right, so this match is
the best of 7 series or some shit.
From Gainesville,
Alright, so this match is the make into the tournament, which means the creator of the title could miss the tournament. We need to put something into here so you actually care about winning or losing the match, David. So if you don't win this match, you're out of the tournament and I'm in.
Then what could happen? We'll have to share play the actual matchup to defend the title. I can record it.
Yeah, we can probably do that. We can probably share play it. Next time that Chris comes over to your place, we could have him have a matchup for the title. So the thing with doing a tournament is that, you know, we're never all on at the same time. For example, say you do the tournament tonight, I'm working. Austin could probably not be on. Levi's almost not never on. So the problem with the tournament is that the matches might never get done.
Unless it depends how it's worked out.
Yeah, that thing depends how stuff works out. So, tournament might not be the greatest of things. Unless we all do like a one-on-one matchup and we have like you, me, Levi, Austin, and whoever else you want to fight for the title and just like fight it out.
Yeah. Oh boy,
we're in for a treat tonight. Both of these superstars look geared up and ready to go. Looking motivated to make an impact here tonight.
TLC matchup or whatever.
Yeah, I wish a whole bunch of compete. Get a whole bunch of people to share play.
No, I think you only share play with. Yeah, you can only share play with one person.
This should be a glorious matchup right here.
Hey, you ain't Bobby Roode. You can't say glorious.
Well, there is a glorious t-shirt. You can say it because you got a t-shirt.
Yeah, I might get that t-shirt. And I'm hoping to probably do a shop order soon around Christmas time. I was kind of telling my mom for Christmas and for my birthday, she really wants to get me something. She just like gave me like totally like give me her credit card so you can order like $500 worth of stuff, and I'll be like, okay.
Well, I hope like around the thousand.
Well, yeah, or give me a gift card. Well, at least I want to order around $1,000 stuff, because I want to try at least get one replica title to add to my mantle of merch.
This will surely be a true mano a mano test. It's amazing. For more than 50 years,
I have that as a surprise for me and find out which replica title it will be.
I think when it's all said and done, we'll be probably, talking about this match the regular world title. These guys Universal. Are going to go to any and all links tonight the red straps. To win this TLC Universal match. Title. We may never see another match I won't get like a women's title because they all basically just look the same. Let's
go. Hey, let's get the SmackDown one. That one actually looks better.
Yeah, the blue one.
The SmackDown colors, yeah.
Let's talk briefly about
maybe,
Christian.
Yeah.
There's disrespectful
we'll
superstars, and then there's this
the one I really want one though, the one I really want right now is the Universal title.
Any given night, and I don't see why tonight is any different.
Oh, Frog Splash.
Let's not overreact here, Michael. You know, I've seen plenty of disrespectful competitors make it all the way to the top over the years.
You dodged my amazing move, and now you know you were punching the air.
He was so mad.
You know, Christian brings so much experience into the ring with him tonight. He's been a mainstay here for over a decade.
Elimination Chamber is a Raw Super Pay-Per-View live from Arizona.
I'm talking Undertaker,
and SmackDown has Fastlane live from Milwaukee in the Wisconsin.
Yeah, and that is that. SmackDown, the Fastlane, that would be the only way to go on DVD.
No,
you can watch the Chamber exclusively on the network.
No, I think the Chamber is going to be on the network too. It's going to be like every other thing.
Yeah.
It's not going to be a network special where they don't make a DVD of it like they did with 2 years ago. The last Chamber.
Yeah, because I noticed too, like Backlash hasn't been out in DVD here.
But for me,
any other SmackDown DVDs that I haven't seen in pay-per-views.
It's like there's I saw No Mercy the other day at HMV, and I'm pretty sure I saw Backlash championship victory, for example.
That came more than a dozen years after Christian made his debut. One?
Yeah, that is it had AJ on the cover holding the title. He just keeps and on the back cover, it had like Becky, Slater, and Rhino. It had the AJ Dean match. Pretty sure it was this year.
It had it been, yeah, it sounds just like it. I guess it's only like for Canada and the UK. I haven't seen it in the US yet.
Well, have you
I know Hell in a Cell came out.
Yeah, Hell in a Cell's out. I know Clash of Champions is out.
I know, yeah, I have that.
The last WWE DVD thing that came out was the Randy Orton one. The Randy Orton Out of Nowhere. Which I don't know if it's like another documentary or it's just like a compilation of his best matches.
Well, to me it looks like having his best matches on there, and then it'll be like here and there you hear him talk about something or whatever. Like a little documentary and then matches in between.
That's what sucks with most wrestling DVDs nowadays. They don't even do like documentary type stuff anymore. All they do is like a compilation of best matches. Like for Brock, now Randy. I like DVDs. For example, the Shield DVD. He was the evolution of the Shield. The life was called the Shield.
Yeah, that was dope.
And that one was a great one. My other favorite one is the Paul Heyman one. I like. I had the Paul Heyman one, but I gave it to Simon because he needed it for his collection. And I watched like a couple of times, and after a while, I talked him off and stuff. gave him that and the other one was the best of Raw and SmackDown moments 2014, I believe, or 2015. Yeah, I think it was 2015 because they had Nikki and Brie on the cover.
There's only two from that series that I'm missing. The Raw 2009, and then I don't remember the other year for Raw and SmackDown.
Yeah, because back in the day, they used to do one for each, but now they just do one for both brands. AJ Styles softened up here. Rolling out of harm's way. Because I know my first ever wrestling DVD I ever had was WrestleMania 28. I bought them at Walmart in the States. I bought WrestleMania 28 on DVD. It had like the whole event on 3 discs, and then it had the Hall of Fame on disc 3. He wants no and I also got a because they do that also a lot at Walmart and stuff. I noticed they do a lot of a like double packs. Like no, you oh crap, face first on the table. They call them like double packs, like kind of like mine. I bought had Survivor Series 2009 on it, and it had the was it the
did you see that? Did you hear?
The DX DVD from like 2006. What the fuck happened to the table? Look at
that. It fell and it broke. And he clutched. I don't
know how much longer he's gonna be able to go.
Stuck
there on the mat.
So yeah, it was the DX DVD from like 2006. And we were called the moment 2006. And he had like Survivor Series 2009. In it.
Oh,
those were my first DVDs I ever bought, and I bought them in the States at Walmart.
Nice.
I haven't bought a wrestling DVD in a while, but because with the network, usually the stuff comes on once in a while.
And he's heading back in. I can't blame
him. Yeah, and they're adding more content on there. I also heard too, well, may or may not happen, but now they might add possibly some indie wrestling on there, like Ring of Honor and stuff.
Yeah, I don't know if that's going to be the network, or if it's going to be what they call a flow jam or flow something. It's a server that's already signed with, I know, Ring of Honor, New Japan. They're going to, it's going to be like a WWE network type of deal, but it's only going to be for independent wrestling companies, if you will.
He's pulling out all the stops tonight.
Yeah. All right, stay there, Christian.
Be lucky if you make this jump.
He doesn't want
scared.
To jump. How about you do it, bitch?
I can't.
That's the thing. Shut up. Gotten better ever since. I'm gonna have to pull you back off the ladder.
Toss to the outside, like yesterday's garbage.
What the hell? What the hell? Oh, headbutt.
He needs to dig way down deep if he wants to keep going.
So,
did
you do your TLC predictions video, or are you not going to do one, or what's going on with that?
No, not really. I mean, I still want to do the best of and wait until that comes out. Talk about all the pay-per-views at once.
Simon's having his what he calls end-of-year show.
He's delivering an old-fashioned butt-kicking right here.
If he does it, I'm still looking to do it.
He wants no part of the outside.
Just in case James plan.
Plans won't change. He told me he wants to do it after, He said he wants to do it after Roblox.
After Roblox. Roblox can do it.
Probably that he was saying the Wednesday after Roblox. I'm already looking at work to take that at least the night off from there if we're gonna do it then. So I'll at least be there if he wants to do it. He's already done the format and everything, so I'm pretty sure he's gonna want to do it.
He doesn't want to do this outside the ring. Well, I don't blame him.
Yeah, we'll see how it goes. Oh.
But if you're gonna do that, you're gonna do a hot seat type of deal? You're gonna do a hangout, or is that gonna just be you, yourself talking?
Yeah. Probably on my own, maybe.
Man, this is one of those matches you just like to sit back and enjoy watching. Yeah, one of those you never want to see in.
I might do a lift after TLC, the best matches of the year kind of deal.
What's going to be on the list?
It's not going to be pay-per-views, it's going to be pay-per-view matches.
I don't know how much
and it's
going to
include takeover
to
matches too, so it's not going to be restricted to just pay-per-views. And it's gonna be just a top 10
list.
Here's
the setup.
Probably gonna do it after TLC or after Roblox. But I probably do it the Monday after.
Yeah. I know what I'll definitely do. I might start doing the reviews again, for next year, especially for WrestleMania and stuff.
Alright.
Trying to get a WrestleMania party going on.
A WrestleMania party.
I don't know if you and Simon are doing one. Yeah.
Delta's gonna try. I mean, I did enjoy doing it with him last year. I don't know if he's gonna do it this year with him and his negative ass. Oh, the cruiserweight is just a bunch of jobs.
No.
I did mine after he did his. And we spent the whole night just complaining after each other because he was telling me if I actually enjoyed the stuff from now more than the stuff from before, that I was uneducated and I should educate myself. You're saying
the thing is, I'm educated and I've seen the cruiserweights before.
And I've seen some of the cruiserweight stuff before.
Yeah, on SmackDown.
And I'm sorry, but they're still better this year than they were before.
Okay. And the thing is, I know some of these guys, if you don't know them, then you get to know them eventually.
Yeah, that's the thing too, is that he has no fucking experience with these dudes. I know Cedric Alexander, for example, watching him on The Independence, I heard a lot about him. TJ Perkins, I know him from his time in TNA. Stuff like that. All Simon knows is that, the jobbers. Oh, good for you. Oh, Style Clash again.
You see, the definition of a jobber for me, you look at it as...
Is James Ellsworth. Yeah, it's James Ellsworth, not deep.
He's a jobber. Brandon Walker,
really
he's a jobber.
And I win, so you don't get to compete for your own title. This one's over.
Yeah,
I'm
for
kidding.
Me, like that, I'm a jobber.
No, how about this? I win this match, which means I have the Money in the Bank briefcase for the hot seat championship. Which means I get to cash it in on the champ.
Somebody else.
But yeah, his thing about like them being jobbers, and I know Chris doesn't like it, but at least Chris has a good sense to actually mention that they're wrestlers and they're not fucking jobbers.
Yeah.
I'll let you make the next match, bro, if you want to do another match.
Haven't been properly introduced. They just announced like who they are, little pieces. We haven't fully seen who they exactly are. Some of them do have a bit of a character and gimmick to them, but not all of them just yet.
The thing is that they are introduced, but not in the traditional way that people like you, David, like you, Chris, and Simon are used to. You know, he was giving me the example of, imagine if KO got introduced like how the Cruiserweights were introduced. You know, they basically had KO sit down and talk about who he is and stuff. The thing is, they did that after he debuted. They did those things where he sat down and said why he turned on Sami Zayn and all that. They did those things.
Yeah.
But he was mentioning the vignettes from before. And I agree, but, you know, would you see like someone like...
Those.
Would you see like someone like TJ Perkins have like a vignette of him yelling and screaming and all that shit? No, you wouldn't. It wouldn't work. So, and I feel like he's not even giving him a chance. I mean, he watched one episode of the Cruiserweight Classic, and he watched 205 Live with like four Raws, and he feels like he feels like he knows the Cruiserweights well enough to bitch about him. I didn't watch the Classic. But I watched it after to educate myself. To educate myself on these guys. Guys like Zack Sabre Jr., Kota Ibushi, Cedric Alexander, TJ Perkins, Brian Kendrick, since he's somewhat changed. Rich Swann, all those guys. I watched to learn on these guys. But he only watched one episode, and it was when the Gargano faced Ciampa. And he knew the two guys from NXT. So he didn't really learn anything new. Then he watched 205 Live, and that is what led to him basically calling that they are jobbers. And I'm sorry, but his excuse of putting guys like Sami Zayn, like Kalisto, like Eric Young in there is fucking ridiculous. Why put in these guys? Sami Zayn weighs 215. Eric Young weighs 225. Like, Kalisto, I understand. I agree. Put the Lucha Dragons in there. They did it with Sin Cara. They might as well have done it with Kalisto.
Yeah, and have it for both brands. Since it's on SmackDown.
Yeah, have them on both brands. I don't care. But him just naming off random people like that, like Sami Zayn. Like, Sami Zayn is a high flyer, but he's also a technical wrestler. Eric Young, he's become more and more of a brawler in the powerhouse, and he actually is a high flyer. The Cruiserweight template is guys who are high-flying, who are exciting. Not guys who are brawlers and technical guys. Even Brian Kendrick, who uses a submission finisher, and TJ, who uses a submission finisher, are high flyers. Mm-hmm. So, but anyways, he doesn't like the Cruiserweights. He probably will never like him. So, hey, shit happens.
It's cup of tea, apparently.
Yep, well, apparently. But, dude, you enjoy the Cruiserweights, right? Right?
Well, yeah, I've been watching them for a long time, especially when they made the announcement. I thought it was going to be really cool to see. It's still going to really just take its time, I think. And now with the new show, it's a better platform for them, besides just Raw all the time and having like two matches. Now they'll actually have more of a storyline. They can have the Cruiserweight title be defended.
Yeah, they have a bigger platform now with 205 Live and Raw now. You know, they can have like short matches on Raw and then just have regular matches on, like, for example, for Raw. So, did you invite me?
Yeah. All right. Just wondering.
And go look if there was any other news in the world of World Wrestling Entertainment. See if anything else broke out. you have received an invitation from David Rivera. Join.
Might go live.
Oh. Well, wait, if you're going to go live, then I might cut my feed out. I'm going to end my broadcast, so. Yeah. Make sure to, well, ladies and gentlemen, that is it. That is my broadcast of WB2K17. I'm going to plug in my good friend, Mr. David Rivera. Go on the Fort Minor Project channel, where he usually broadcasts his video game shtick. He always does videos, too, usually when he's feeling like it. Make sure to subscribe to him. Make sure to subscribe to Rafael LeDuc Page Guy channel for more content on WWE and MMA. And with that being said, it is time to go off the air. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us, and have yourself a very good day.